Libras, what's up, y'all? Welcome back to the channel. This will be a Who's Talking About You reading, y'all. We're gonna see who talking about you, why they talking about you, and what they want to say. Who's talking about Libra? Somebody that's not with you, somebody that say they don't want to be with you, swear up and down that they're not investing into you, but this person still like talking to you from time to time. It's like to everybody else, they don't want them to know. This somebody is trying to keep you a secret. They want everybody to think that you're a bad investment, but they'll try to like fuck with you. They'll try to talk to you. They'll try to link with you. Whoever this is, they single. They not in a relationship. This could be a Cancer, Pisces, or a Scorpio. You feel like this person want to give to other options, and this is why they not investing into you. They won't ever change. You feel like they spread their money equally with all of their options. Whoever this is, you feel like they got a lot of people texting their phone or a lot of people talking to them, and you know that. They texting their ex. Y'all feel like this person texting their ex. They getting drunk, thinking about an ex, throwing up and shit, joking about it with other people. Y'all feel like this person that did a lot of shit. Like a lot of foul shit. They always crying about shit. Some of y'all could have lost your phone, or you could have told this person you lost your phone or something like that. Some of y'all may be hiding a spare phone, but you feel like you don't have to tell this person that because you're not with them no way. Y'all feel like this person weak, and you only really want to deal with them when they got money in their pocket, whoever this is. But you don't feel like they y'all, you don't feel like they all... Whoever this is, it's like you only want to deal with them when they got money in their pocket, but you feel like they don't ever have no money. It's like you don't ever got nothing. Like, you can't give me shit. This could be a Leo, a Taurus, Scorpio. And you also feel like they dealing with somebody else. A lot of other people, two different people. You feel like you know about this because they could have told you about it. You feel like this person is stressed out because they don't really want new love. They want like a family. They want to be happy. They want to sit down. You feel like this person wants to make the right decision, but there's so much drama going on right now. And it's so many burdens that they can't make this decision. It's like they need to let go of all of these burdens. They dealing with too many third parties. You feel like this person just needs to make up their mind. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Leo. You feel like they just holding back from somebody that they really want to be with. And you feel like that's their fault because they the ones that's not motivated to go towards what they want. And that's why things are not working out for them. You feel like they lying about how much they have. They lying about their success. And it's like, y'all could have a child with this person. This could be like your child's father or your child's mother for my man. Y'all feel like this person be lying about how much money they got in their pocket. They lie about being happy. They lying about not being heartbroken, and they act like they can handle it. But you feel like this person could go through a bottle of liquor in 2.5 seconds. Some of y'all feel like they just won't change. It's like you don't like the way your life is going, but you don't want to do nothing different about it. Y'all could be trying to confuse this person or lie to them about who they should invest into or about who they should be with, because you do want to keep this person around financially. So y'all watching to see if they gonna go back to this other person, to this Queen of Pentacles, could be an earth sign, or another air sign. Y'all feel like this person just gonna end up leaving anyway. Some of y'all, this could be a same-sex connection or somebody that's in the LGBTQ community that's talking about you. LGBTQ T. I be always putting the Q on there. Somebody tell me what the Q mean. But y'all feel like they gonna run back to somebody from their past, and you feel like this person got them blocked, or this person don't want to deal with them right now. So you feel like it's the perfect opportunity to get them to fuck with you. Tell me about this other person. This other person could be an earth sign. You feel like this other person is not toxic, they good for them, but it makes you mad that they actually want to be with this person. You could have gotten to it with this person in the past, or you feel like you and this person had an argument, and just ever since then you just hated this person's guts, or you just didn't want them to be with this person. It's like, well, you could be with anybody else but not this person, because they just, I don't like them, they too confident for me, like they challenge me, they're the only person that'll put me in my head. Or y'all feel like this person the only person that could press your buttons, and it's like, why haven't you moved away from this person yet? Like, this is supposed to be somebody that's old love in your life. Like, I never thought you would fall in love with this person. Like, y'all felt like they would never ever want to be with this person. Like, you would never want a life with them, you would never want a family with them, like you would never want anything serious with them. And you feel like you assuming that was the wrong thing to do. It's like, why did I ever think that? Why did I assume that? You felt like this person would make up their mind a long time ago, but it's like, damn, I guess not. Your family could have told you about, they family could have told you about this person. Or your family, some of y'all, your family could have been lurking and told you about this person. Or they family could have like expressed to you that they was happy with a third party. But they had people that was causing drama in the relationship, and everybody know that. Your family could have told you to let this go. Both of y'all families could have told y'all to let this go. This could be one of them situations where your family don't really get along with them. You don't really get along with their family. Like, none of y'all really mix. But you were trying to get past that. Y'all were trying to heal from that or get over that. But you feel like it's nothing here. It's like, we just keep testing each other's boundaries. We just keep trying to figure out if we could cheat with each other, if we in relationships and shit like that. Y'all feel like y'all just playing a game with each other. It's like, we really don't want each other. We only deal with each other for sex, and we really don't even, we don't have any emotions tied to it. This could be somebody that was like a sneaky link. This could have been how y'all met or how y'all started off, or could be somebody that was in a relationship when y'all got together, or they was already, it probably wasn't serious. I don't feel like this was something that was serious. It could have been just sexual, but then you tried to turn it into a relationship to see if it would work. And y'all looking back on it like, damn, that was a foolish decision. Like, I invested money into this, I invested time into this, and they in love with somebody else. You feel like they in love with somebody else. It's like, I did all of this shit and they in love with somebody else. You feel like they gonna go give this other person everything, and it kind of makes you jealous. It's like, I don't want them to give this other person everything. I'm gonna keep trying to hold them off. I'm gonna keep trying to delay them. And you gonna keep trying this. It's like, you're trying this because you want this person to like, y'all just realized that it could possibly work out between them and this other person. And it's like, I don't want that for you. because I feel like you manipulated me, or because I feel like you didn't give me what I wanted. So I don't want you to have that. Y'all want this person to go to work, make money, cheat, and not like put any effort with they person. It's like, I don't want you to work on your situation with the person that you want to be with. I just want you to go to work, make your money, and cheat with me. Like, don't give them anything. Don't give that person anything, the person you love. It's like, I don't want you to. So it's like y'all making demands. It's like you want to be this person's side person, but you want to make demands. It's like, no, you can't give your person nothing. No, you can't. That, y'all, Libra, let that shit go. Let that shit go. Some of y'all have another options. It's a King of Pentacles coming out. Y'all got somebody else, and I don't know if you the third party in that situation too, but you feel like you getting ready to end that situation because you feel like this person's selfish with their money. So y'all want these people to take care of y'all or give y'all money, but it's like, I'll be on the side, it's cool, but just make sure you bring me money every now and then, and just don't give your person nothing. Don't do that. Don't put yourself in that position. Like, put an end to that shit. Because these people are still going to change. These people are still going to transform, because eventually they will get tired of that shit. Eventually they will get tired of being told that they can't go towards somebody that they actually do love. Eventually they will get tired of feeling like they're being possessed, like feeling like somebody's controlling them. And they're not happy in a situation. It's like, I'm just here giving all of my attention, giving all my time, giving all my money, but what am I getting out of this? Because I don't really, it's no love here. So these people are growing up and realizing that they need the love too. They can't just be used. Them being used is not what they want. They're looking at the situation like, we don't love each other. And y'all don't. Honestly, y'all don't love each other. You want to be by yourself. Y'all want to be alone. Y'all don't even want to deal with none of these people. But you feel like, since they keep wanting to ask for sex, it's like, okay, well, I'll let you go one day. I'll let you do what you want to do one day, but you're going to be disappointed until then. So y'all method is like acting like you cool with these people, and then it's like, I'm going to confuse you. I'm going to make you think that you getting something out of this, and I'm just going to place all of my burdens on your back. I'm just going to give you all of my bills. Let these people move on, Libra, or y'all will have like a... Let these people move on. You trying to confuse people and play the part of a side man or a side woman, that's not good. That's not good. I ain't going to even lie, y'all. Go be with somebody that's going to give you everything you need. That's not going to keep you on the side. That's not going to keep you a secret. Somebody that knows that you deserve like a happy life. You can get the finances, the love, the money. You can get all of that if you just go get it, find it with somebody that wants to give it to you. Somebody that wants to be in love with you. Don't just settle for being somebody's like jump off. Don't just settle for, okay, well, if you want to fuck, just give me some money. No, don't do that, Libra. No. No, no, no. Your body is worth way more than that. I don't give a fuck if you're a man or a woman. Your body is worth way more than that. Go find a motherfucker that you love. Go find a motherfucker that's in love with you. And go build that type of life with that person. Because I guarantee you, it will be way more rewarding. It'll be way more rewarding versus you waking up in the morning looking at somebody that you ain't supposed to be laying next to, and you thinking to yourself, I don't even fucking like you. Like, I low-key hate your guts, or I low-key just don't want to be here, but you giving me some money right now. You taking care of me right now. You supporting me right now. So I guess I kick it with you. That's a disappointing life. Y'all not happy doing this. Y'all are sad doing this. So stop doing it. End the conflict and go be happy. Go get what you want. Like, y'all don't have to feel like y'all have unfinished business with somebody just because you have a child with this person. You don't have to be with them. You don't have to be with this person. Once you realize that it's not going to work, or once y'all both realize, oh, they ain't marriage material. Not for me, they ain't. Once they realize, oh, they ain't marriage material for me, and you realize the same thing, it's a wrap. It's a wrap, because if y'all can't build nothing with each other, it ain't no reason for y'all to even be around each other. All y'all gonna do is bring heartbreak and betrayal into each other's lives. We got the Ten of Swords. All y'all gonna do is bring constant heartbreak and constant betrayal and constant pain into y'all lives. And it's only gonna be you and this person that's gonna be affected by that. Y'all gonna be walking around and you gonna look up. Like, time passes so fast in life and people don't realize that. You gonna look up one day and it's gonna have been 20 years that have passed or 15 years that have passed. And whatever the time frame is, you gonna look up one day and it's gonna be like, I cannot believe I played this game for all of these years when I could have been settled down. I could have been happy. I could have been married to somebody I actually like. I could have been married or in a happy relationship with somebody that I love, like I can actually stand the sight of them. You're gonna look up one day and you're gonna regret your decision to stay and play this game with this person. And this person gonna do the same thing, because I'm telling you, time passes fast. And when you look up in 20 years and you realize the only thing you've ever done in your life was play the stupid game of betrayal back and forth with your baby daddy or your baby mama, the people you have kids with, you're gonna be so sad and so hurt. And I'm not saying that to be, you know, rude. I'm saying that to be honest. When you look up and you realize that is all that you have accomplished, that's all that you have done, it is going to make you look at life like, what the fuck did I do? And you're going to wish that you would have made a different decision. At that point, your focus is going to become like, damn, let me make sure my child don't go through no shit like this. Make sure you show them that they don't have to go through no shit like that. The best way you can do that is by detaching yourself from this situation and going to find real love for yourself. Don't allow your child to see, or your kids to see, like, oh, it's cool for me to, like, just be daddy or mommy's side piece or sleep around with daddy or mommy while they in relationships. Your kids shouldn't be seeing shit like that. Kids, like, grow up, they process shit like that, and they start to think that shit like that is okay for them to do. I don't have to love the person that I have a child with. I'm just gonna, no. Like, y'all want y'all kids to go down a different direction. So you gotta lead by example. You have to be a different person. And whoever this person is, they not gonna help you do that. Y'all not gonna help each other do that. Y'all not gonna help each other grow. Y'all gonna actually bring each other down even more. And I'm sorry to say that, y'all, but that's what I'm seeing in the cards. What are they saying about you? Why are they talking about you? They telling people that they don't fuck with you, that they released you. They also talking about your financial circumstances. They telling people that you got money. Some of y'all could have took this person to court. They telling people that you only got money because you're getting child support from them, or because you took them to court for some type of money. They telling people that's the only way that you getting paid. That's the only way that you getting money out of them. And they also telling people that they be bored when they come around you, when they pull up on you. All you want to do is talk about your problems, talk about other people, talk about your bills. And they also telling people that they feel like they could do better, or if they leave you behind, they could find better. Oh, I look better, or I got my shit together. This somebody that's talking a whole lot of shit about you. And they also telling people that you know about the person that they want to be with, but you jealous of that. They telling people that you jealous of what they got going on. And this is why you want to keep them, like, being non-committal, or keep them cheating with you. They telling people that they ready for new love, and they feel like you already went towards new love. It's like you already dealing with somebody. So it's like, why are you trying to hold me back and make me be alone? They doing this to themselves. They doing this to themselves, though. They holding themselves back. This person feel like the person that you... They telling people that the person that you dealing with is in a relationship with somebody else. So they feel like... They telling people that you just going through endings all over. It's like you just keep experiencing endings. You just keep experiencing betrayals and heartbreaks, and that's, they telling people, it's because you bring that into other people's lives. Yeah, they telling people that you experiencing all of these betrayals and heartbreaks because you betrayed people around you, you betrayed them, you betrayed other people. It's like, this somebody that's low-key hurt or low-key pissed off at the fact that they feel like they fucked up some things in their own life. It's like, I held myself back by dealing with you. But at the same time, they looking at you like, well, I didn't know. Like, you could have told me that you was dealing with other people. You could have told me that you didn't want to commit. Or you could have told me that you had all these secrets and that you just wanted motherfuckers for money. This somebody that feel like I got a child with you, like, you could at least let me in on that little secret. Like, all you had to do was be real with me and let me know that you was fucking with me for money, or that you was fucking with a lot of other people for money, or other people for money. Because there's three people out here, and they felt like they had to, like, throw their relationship in your face so you can know that they was going to be in and out with you and not care about what they do to you. So this is somebody that was trying to break you. It's like, oh, you think shit good? You think I'm cheating so I could, like, give you what you want or make you happy? Nah, I'm cheating so I could break your spirit. I'm cheating so I could let you know that I won't choose you no more. Like, you won't never be the one for me no more. Like, I'm cheating so I could let you know that I'm always try to be with this other person or want this other person. But I don't really think y'all care about that. I don't really think y'all care about that, because you're getting what you want by keeping them away from this other person. That's your whole goal anyway, to keep them away from this other person and to get their money. So it's like, they're giving you exactly what you want, and you don't even have to be their main person to get it from them. So this person got a dumb logic or a dumb way that they thinking. Y'all still getting what y'all want out of this person, and even if you have to be single, you still end up coming up because they give you their money. You don't have to be with them. Like, this is somebody that they playing themselves, they fooling themselves by telling themselves that, oh, well, I'm getting over on Libra, I'm playing Libra. No, you're playing yourself. That's what you're doing. So somebody just don't realize that they being dumb. Like, you're not supposed to be giving all that shit. If a motherfucker is supposed to be a side person, you're supposed to be giving side person privileges, meaning too much of nothing. This somebody that'll get a whole bag and think, oh, you're a side person. Okay. But you're not giving me side person treatment. Yeah, you may not show me off. Yeah, you may not put me in the spotlight, but you still trying to do stuff for me behind closed doors. You still trying to help me out like you help your person out. You still trying to help me out like you want to do for your person. So how am I? This is somebody that's kind of like slow, I'm not going to lie. Y'all could have been trying to hide a pregnancy or keep this hidden. You didn't know that this information was going to come out for some of you that are pregnant. But this could be getting ready to, like, some of y'all are already there. They talking about this. They telling people about this. Talking about you being pregnant. Telling people that you are, or telling people that they, who's the Empress? Or they could be throwing a pregnancy in your face. They could be telling you that somebody else is pregnant. They could be telling you that somebody, who's the Empress? Okay, yeah. They could be telling you that somebody else is pregnant, like, to, like, cause some drama. This somebody that's, like, throwing stuff in your face to cause drama. They want to make it their point to let you know, oh, I'm not going to work on this, or, oh, I'm not going to fuck with you. This somebody that's purposely trying to hurt you, and they're watching you to see if it's working. Like, did I hurt your feelings? Did I slow you down? Whew. Yeah. And they want to be in a relationship with somebody else. They feel like they already found their soulmate. They just pissed off at you and they want to get revenge on you. And this person playing this game ain't doing nothing but holding them back. Honestly. And you too. Because y'all could be on to bigger and better things. Y'all could be doing something that you actually like. or being with somebody that you actually like, and this person ain't doing it for you. Because for one, you already know what they want. You've been gave up on this, because it's like, why am I gonna keep myself stuck when I know that you in love with somebody else? That's why I lie to you. That's why I play you. And that's why I don't care about you finding that out, because I know you in love with somebody else. I know you don't have any emotions tied to this situation. So I don't give a fuck about you losing your relationship. You goddamn right I feel some type of way. You goddamn right I'm kind of jealous about it, or I envy it, because you got me fucked up. Yeah, I feel like y'all making the wrong decision. Like, you really should just back out of this. But it's like, you don't want this person to win. You want both of these people to lose. You want this person to be angry. It's like, you don't want this person to feel like things are going to work out in their life. But I don't know if y'all feel like it's working. You feel like this person still lying to you, or you feel like they still playing the same game, coming back around, lying about wanting to do something serious or make things work, and they honestly do not be, you know, this somebody that be lying, they be gaslighting. So it's like, if you gaslight me, I'm gonna gaslight you. I'm gonna keep secrets from you. And it's like, y'all just gotta get this war up. This draining, y'all. Y'all gotta get this war up with whoever this person is, Libra. What do they want to say to you? They want to tell you that they felt blinded by a lot of the things that happened between the two of y'all. They felt blinded by a lot of the things that you did. And they also feel like that's part of the reason why they won't move forward now. They feel like that's part of the reason why they can't trust the person that they actually love now, because of you and what y'all went through. It's like, you just wanted me for what I had, or you just needed me for the money, or you didn't really care about me. This is somebody that's kind of coming to the conclusion, like, damn, like, what if my next person is going to be like this because I went through this with you? They have hidden emotions that they want to tell you about. And it's like, they feel like in a way you holding them back, but they know it's no love between the two of y'all. They're just doing this because they feel like it's a toxic attachment. They feel like controlled. They also want to tell you that they read your text messages. They went through your messages, and they know that you've been dealing with other people, third parties. This person went through your phone, and they looking at you in like a negative way. And they also feel like you use them and you use other people. This somebody is looking at you in a, like, they want to tell you, like, they feel like you've been doing, like, I'm not gonna lie, y'all, whole shit. This somebody that feel like you've been doing a lot of shit behind closed doors, and they had to go through your phone to see all of this shit, or to find all of this shit out. They feel like they want to tell you about this because they not moving on from this betrayal. They not gonna let up on this. Like, this, they feel like what they found out, it hurt their feelings. It put so much shit on their plate. It put so much shit on their shoulders, gave them a lot to think about. Like, damn, it was never gonna work. It was never really meant to work between me and you. There's somebody that's realizing that they just got themselves caught up in a bad situation, or they felt trapped. They also found out, for some of y'all, they found out about you being pregnant by somebody else too. Building a family with somebody else, telling somebody that you wanted to have a family with them or kids with them. But it's some drama going on between you and that person. And they also feel like you lied about having drama with the person that they wanted to be with. They feel like they're sad over the fact that they believed you and trusted you when you said that the person that they wanted to be with was like coming for you or focused on you or only motivated or getting their answers from you or something like that. Y'all could have lied and said that they person reached out to you and said that they was and told them about something that y'all did. This y'all could be spying on the person that they want to be with. And it's like you listened to some type of information and you took that and you spent the story and said, oh, well, this person told me that y'all did this together or y'all went here. So y'all could have used something as an excuse or played on somebody's intelligence or flipped the story and told this person that they were like broke because they were given to a third party. And it could have made this person like paranoid. Because this person was wondering, like, who told you the information that you knew about? But y'all were watching the person that they were with to get this information, though. So this person not changing because they feel like they keep getting caught up by the person that they want to be with. And they feel like they keep getting caught up. They feel like they keep getting caught up, period. But they not worried about getting caught up by you. They're worried about getting caught up by the person that they want to be with. But they feel like this person, they don't want nothing to do with them. They feel like they don't want nothing to do with this person. They don't want to talk to them. They also found out about you sleeping with somebody that you said you had blocked. This could be somebody you said it wasn't working with, you wasn't fucking with. Could be this could be somebody that they treat like family. This could be somebody they treat like family, somebody close to them. The Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Just somebody close to them that y'all could have been dealing with. You could have said you cut this person off and you still like fucking around with this person. Okay. But you could have told this person that you wasn't dealing with this person because you didn't want them to go back to the person that they wanted to be with. They also want to tell you that they know about that. This person want to expose a lot of secrets to you that they know about. They could have been going out getting drunk because they've been thinking about the fact that they kept themselves stuck in a negative cycle. And they could have been partying with like some friends or people that was keeping a lot of secrets from them. Because one of their friends could have been one of your options. Some of y'all could have like been fucking with one of their friends and this could be the person that... I don't know. Let's see here. Who are these options? Y'all could have felt like this person was happy with their options. This could be what this is. Y'all didn't care though, because you got other people that you dealing with and you feel like it's other people that keep telling you that it's not going to work with you and this person. So it's like, I'm not finna stick around. If I know we not meant for each other, we ain't it, go be in your relationship. But y'all want to keep yourself around. It's like, you can go be in your relationship, but you're going to keep cheating with me so you can never be in your relationship. I'm going to keep weakening you. I'm going to keep breaking this up for you because I don't want you to have it. Yeah, I tell you to go be in it, but that don't mean that I'm going to let you ever have it. So y'all want this person to not have success. This is somebody that you're trying to purposely hold back. They're going to end up making up their mind, though, because they got a lot of people around them that's redirecting them in another direction. then they also know about, for some of y'all, yes, they definitely know about you connecting with, like, hold on. Yeah, they know about you connecting with somebody close to them, somebody that they cool with. They know about you dealing with that person. And that disappointed them. They feel like you really tested their boundaries. Because this patient, they feel like they were patient with you. They waited on you. And they didn't know that you were like dealing with the person that they were close to. They feel like that's like a strong line or a strong boundary to cross. They felt like you would have more morals. Or I ain't gonna say more morals. This person felt like you would eventually be that person that could possibly be the one for them. So it's like, oh, well, if people keep saying that they dealing with somebody close to me, that's a lie. That's a lie. They not doing that. But this person feel like I missed out on an opportunity in love, or I missed out on an opportunity to have love in my life. And then I find out that this shit is true. I find out that you really did deal with somebody that was close to me. And now I'm aware of the fact that I just need to move the fuck on. So this is somebody that feel like they finding out a lot of your secrets, and they want to like basically expose them secrets to you, or tell you about them secrets, Libra. So yeah, be strong, y'all. And when life pulls you in a different direction, when life pulls you in a new direction, it's always best that you go with the flow of life. Take that new direction. Do not keep yourself stuck in a situation that's been burdening you from the start anyway. Don't do that to yourself. Don't hurt yourself in that way, y'all. It's time for y'all to like realize when it's time for you to move forward in your life, okay? So yeah, that's who's talking about y'all, Libra. Thank you for watching, y'all. Don't forget to hit the like button, share, and subscribe. Bye, y'all.